Welcome to India Business Insights. Access to finance is a critical enabler for the agriculture sector, helping farmers and agribusinesses overcome the inherent challenges of high upfront costs, long production cycles, and price volatility. However, many smallholder farmers in India still lack adequate access to financial services. In this video, we will explore the role of both microfinance and macro-level agricultural finance in supporting the growth and resilience of the agriculture industry. We will delve into the unique financial needs of farmers and agricultural firms, the innovative financing models and technologies that are expanding access to credit, savings and risk management tools, and the policy interventions that are shaping the agricultural finance landscape. We will cover the finance availability to the agricultural sector. By the end of this video, you will have a comprehensive understanding of the agriculture finance ecosystem and the pathways to ensuring that farmers from smallholders to large commercial operations can access the capital and financial services they need to thrive. From a business point of view, microfinance and macro-level agricultural finance play a complementary role in supporting the growth and resilience of the agriculture industry. Microfinance business models. Microfinance institutions, MFIs, use alternative financial intermediation systems to offer banking services to marginal people where collateral-based conventional banking has not been effective. They facilitate collateral-free lending through close loan monitoring and possess distinct capabilities to collect savings via donations and deposits. MFIs can be chartered as non-governmental organizations, banks, or non-bank financial institutions. NGO MFIs tend to make smaller loans to poorer borrowers, especially women, but at higher costs and interest rates. While most MFIs are profitable in an accounting sense, only about one-third are economically profitable after considering the opportunity costs of capital. Macro-level agricultural finance. At the macro level, governments and development agencies provide policy support and financing to create an enabling environment for the entire agriculture sector. This includes investments in infrastructure, technology adoption, and risk mitigation. Macro-level finance also supports the expansion of agricultural lending by commercial banks through credit lines, risk guarantees, and interest rate subsidies. By addressing systematic challenges and promoting sustainable growth, macro-level finance helps attract private investment and foster innovation in agriculture. However, it is often constrained by limited public resources and competing priorities in developing countries. Challenges and opportunities. Both microfinance and macro-level agricultural finance face challenges such as limited financial literacy, inadequate rural infrastructure, and vulnerability to environmental risks. Digitalization of financial services offers opportunities to overcome these barriers and expand the reach of both approaches. Digital platforms can facilitate access to information, markets, and financial services for farmers while also reducing transaction costs and improving efficiency. However, the adoption of digital financial services is still limited in many rural areas due to poor connectivity and lack of digital literacy. Unique financial needs. Farmers and agricultural firms in India have unique financial needs that require tailored solutions to support their growth and productivity. These needs can be categorized as follows. Working capital needs. Farmers require access to affordable and timely credit to purchase essential inputs like seeds, fertilizers, pesticides, and to cover labor costs during the plantation and harvesting seasons. Agricultural firms also need working capital to fund their day-to-day operations such as procurement, storage, and transportation of agricultural commodities. Investment capital. Farmers and agricultural firms often need long-term financing to invest in farms mechanization, irrigation systems, post-harvest infrastructure, and other capital-intensive assets that can improve productivity and efficiency. Risk mitigation. The agricultural sector is highly susceptible to weather-related risks, crop failures, and price volatility. Farmers and agricultural firms require access to crop insurance and other risk management tools to protect their investments and livelihoods. Aggregation and market linkages. Small and marginal farmers often lack the scale and bargaining power to access formal credit and markets. Financing the needs to support the formation and growth of farmer-producer organizations, FPOs, and other aggregation models that can help farmers access credit, inputs, and markets more effectively. Technological adoption. Adoption of modern agricultural technologies such as precision farming, digital platforms, and value-added processing requires access to financing to help farmers and firms invest in these innovations. Challenges in accessing finance. Despite these diverse financial needs, farmers and agricultural firms in India face several challenges in accessing formal credit. These include lack of awareness about available financial products, lack of collateral, complex application procedures, high interest rates, and limited credit history. To address these challenges, a multi-pronged approach is required, involving collaboration between government, financial institutions, and other stakeholders. Local financial institutions' role. Regional rural banks, RRBs. RRBs are commercial banks that specifically target rural areas. As of March 2024, there are 45 RRBs with a network of over 21,000 branches. They provide short-term and long-term loans for agricultural operations, machinery, and infrastructure development. RRBs had outstanding credit of Rs. 4.25 lakh CR as of March 2024, of which Rs. 2.13 lakh CR, 50%, was for agriculture and allied activities. Cooperative societies. Primary agricultural credit societies are village-level cooperative institutions that provide direct credit to farmers. There are over 98,000 societies in India as of 2024. They are an important source of short-term and medium-term loans for agricultural activities. Cooperative banks, which are the apex institutions of these societies, had outstanding credit of Rs. 7.56 lakh CR as of March 2024, with 65% going towards agriculture and allied sectors. Microfinance institutions. Self-help groups, SHGs, have emerged as an important channel for microfinance to small and marginal farmers. There are over 12 million SHGs in India as of 2024, mobilizing savings and providing loans to members, often in partnership with local banks. These local institutions have better reach and understanding of the needs of farmers in their regions compared to large commercial banks. They are able to access risks and provide credit more effectively to underserved segments like smallholders. Government schemes. The Government of India has launched several schemes to improve agricultural finance and risk management in recent years. Number 1. Kisan Credit Card KCC Scheme. Launched in 1998, KCC provides affordable credit to farmers for crop production, animal husbandry, and other agricultural activities. As of March 2021, around 19.67 CR KCCs have been issued with a credit limit of over Indian rupee 6.78 lakh CR. Number 2, Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana PMFBY. Launched in 2016, PMFBY gives crop insurance coverage to farmers against crop losses due to natural calamities, pests, or diseases. As of 2020, over 5.61 CR farmers were insured under the scheme with a total sum insured of Indian rupee 2,37,000 CR. Number 3, Modified Interest Subvention Scheme MISS. MISS provides concessional short-term agri loans to farmers practicing crop husbandry and allied activities at an interest rate of 7% per annum. An additional 3% subvention is given to prompt tree payment, reducing the effective rate to 4% per annum. Number 4, Agriculture Infrastructure Fund AIF. Launched under the Atmanirbhar Bharat package, AIF aims to address infrastructure gaps, and mobilize investment in agriculture infrastructure. These schemes have helped increase agricultural productivity, reduce poverty in rural areas, and create job opportunities. Agricultural credit dispersion in India increased from Indian rupee 8.53 lakh crore in 2014-15 to Indian rupee 15.96 lakh crore in 2019-20, recording a growth of 87%. The interim budget 2024-25 presented by the Union Minister of Finance and Corporate Affairs Nirmala Sitharaman in February 2024 highlighted the government's focus on farmers' welfare and boosting rural demand. It mentioned that every year under PM Kisan Samman Yojana, direct financial assistance is provided to 11.8 crore farmers, including marginal and small farmers, while crop insurance is given to 4 crore farmers under PM Fasal Bima Yojana. The budget also promised to step up value addition in the agriculture sector and boost farmers' income, promote private and public investment in post-harvest activities, including aggregation, modern storage, efficient supply chains, primary and secondary processing, and marketing and branding to ensure faster growth of the agriculture and food processing sector. According to the quarterly estimates for the fourth quarter, January to March of FY 2023-24, India's real GDP growth accelerated to 7.8% in Q4, with the agriculture, livestock, forestry, and fishing sector growing by 0.6%. In March 2024, credit for agriculture and allied activities expanded by 19.7% compared to the previous year. In March 2023, the year-over-year growth in agricultural credit was 20%, indicating that while agricultural credit growth remained strong at nearly 20%, it did see a slight moderation from the previous year's level. Despite these efforts, Indian agriculture still faces various risks such as weather variability, frequent natural disasters, uncertainties in crop production and market prices, lack of effective rural infrastructure and market information asymmetry. These factors not only pose risks to the livelihood and income of farmers, but also hinders the overall development of the sector. To address these challenges, the Government of India has been working with international organizations like UNDP to develop innovative solutions. In April 2024, UNDP's Financial Resilience in Agriculture, FRA initiative, formally launched a Community of Practice, COP, for government officials, designed and implementing national agricultural insurance programs for smallholder farmers. The COP includes representatives from 18 countries, including India, Bangladesh, Ethiopia, Tanzania, and Uganda, as the five core FRA countries. The workshop aimed to connect, share ambitions and lessons, and begin designing roadmaps for integrating agricultural insurance into national development agendas and priorities. India's PMFBY scheme has been highlighted as an excellent example of the successful mechanism that can change the landscape of farmers in many countries. The Indian government is eager to work alongside the FRA in other countries, sharing lessons, technologies, and capacities. Moving forward, the FRA initiative plans to work with public and private partners in the five core countries to design and implement innovative national agricultural insurance programs. The goal is to bolster smallholder farmers' financial resilience and accelerate the pace of adaptation to climate change through a unique market systems approach. In conclusion, while the Government of India has made significant strides in improving agricultural finance and risk management through various schemes, more needs to be done to address the complex challenges faced by the sector. Collaborations with international organizations and the adoption of innovative solutions will be crucial in ensuring the financial security and resilience of Indian farmers in the face of growing climate risks and market uncertainties. That's all for today. As we have seen, access to the right financial tools and services can be truly transformative for farmers and agribusinesses. Whether it's small-scale microloan empowering smallholder farmers or large-scale agriculture development programs backed by governments and international organizations, finance is a critical enabler for increasing productivity, building resilience, and unlocking new opportunities in the agriculture sector. While significant progress has been made in expanding financial inclusion for farmers, there is still much work to be done. Innovative solutions, supportive policies, and greater private sector participation will be key to ensuring that all players in the agricultural value chain can access the capital and risk management tools they need to thrive. If you found this overview of the agricultural finance landscape informative, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more videos exploring the latest trends, technologies, and best practices shaping the future of business in India. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next video.